Alright, what's up, guys? Time for another video. I'm gonna follow up my recent video with this, which I've indicated this in the previous video, but this video is gonna be about this specific thing, even though I said it in another video, but the video was another subject, right, and I put it in there. Whether you're gay or straight, this is a separate video on shit that you shouldn't do. If you're gay, don't do this shit, and if you're straight, don't do this shit. If you're a straight guy, don't do this shit, and if you're a straight woman, don't do this shit. And if you're a gay guy, don't be the guy that does this shit, and if you're the other gay guy, don't do this shit. Or if you're the girl that's gay or whatever, don't do this shit, and don't be that other chick that does this shit. Like, okay. If you follow me here carefully here, I will choose the straight people first here, because I said in the beginning of the other video that I'm a straight male in a straight relationship, and my partner is me, both 50 years old, and we're both 50 years old and gray and slightly balding, right? And we also believe that gray is the new blue or green or pink hair, in a sense that, oh, they look down on you for being gray now, for my opinion. But anyway, for my example in a straight relationship, right, and say, make an example of why I'm happy. For example, at my age, I would find it ridiculous, like I said too, to be sneaking around with my partner's back, behind my partner's back, right? Maybe dyeing my hair and then combing over the bald spot, or if I can afford it, get the hair transplantation shit. And by the way, my partner would think something's up if I did. You know what? If you're straight, don't be that straight guy that's looking for anything greener to be on the other side of the tracks. And be like, I wouldn't be like I said, cutting and dyeing my hair and combing over the bald spot and going looking for some younger chicks and driving some kind of convertible or some kind of car somewhere and going to some bar where the chicks out of college drinking. I said in my other video too, there was guys I worked in the factories with, older guys, who did that shit, got themselves some younger chick or something like that, and they're showing off, smooching in the parking lot, having their significant other drive them to work in a parking lot so they could show off, and she drops them off so they could smooch in a parking lot. It actually, stupid idiots out there that take pride in being the quote dirty old man, I think that's disgusting and stupid. But yeah, there are guys that were like that. And I said before in the other video that some people, whether they like you or even they don't like you, right, jokingly or maliciously, other straight guys that engage in shit like that, even when they're married. For example, I said in videos previously that they would jokingly or maliciously, if they're not your friends maliciously, if they're kind of your friends jokingly, call you the word that rhymes with maggot, that's the no-no word on YouTube, the word that rhymes with maggot. You would have other straight guys call you that if you don't do like they do, go to bars, whether they're married or not, and brag about how many younger chicks you want to pick up in bars and take home behind the wife's back. Anyway, I compare that with the gay side that I didn't get to yet, that why we can, how, anyway, I want to say how, try to tell these people that are on that gay and trans side of the tracks that indeed I'm making my point that straight people get called that word too, that gay slur. Even though you're straight, you can get called that gay slur, right? For not doing like I mentioned, all right? But anyway, yeah, I spent a lot too much time on that. But yeah, me being in a straight relationship with my significant other that I'm proud of being in, I'm just telling you, don't be that guy. I'm not that guy. Don't be that guy that does shit like that, sneaking around, combing, combing your hair over to a bald spot, dyeing your hair, and looking for, even if guys that work in factories, different places would make fun of you and call you the word that rhymes with maggot, don't do that. Yeah, okay, I spent too much time on that. So, and also, if you're a straight woman on the side of the tracks, and of course my partner never does that to me, but if you out there are a woman in a straight relationship, and this is the rhetoric like I listen to, like at a woman with a big neck tattoo, Roma Army, this is her bag, up her alley, how she sticks up for guys. She preaches this too. Don't be that woman that treats your guy like shit, of course. Common sense. Me in a straight relationship, me and my partner don't engage in bullshit like that. And I said on the gay side, on the straight side of the tracks, to be fair, before I start on the gay side. Two extremes a straight guy don't need to be. One, being a pathetic simp, you know, begging for some chick in some bar's approval that ain't even interest to you, that'll take all your money and blah, 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 which I never had to deal with that. And plus, the other side that I would never want to be is go picking up some younger chick with, like, go to some bar, like, probing for the ones that are lesser self-esteem, so I can be mean to and control and lesser self. Look for the ones that have lesser self-esteem. That, you know, guy that is overly macho, as opposed to being the pathetic simp. You can have the overly macho, aggressive. Looks for chicks that have less self-esteem, so mentally and physically abuse them, make them so that they, there's nothing greener on our other side, and they gotta take your shit. Alright, I covered that. Straight dude and chick, both of them, shit that they shouldn't do, okay? Now on the gay side, this is why I make, fun of the certain aspects of being gay. Two aspects of being gay that I would never be, and that's why I would never particularly want to be gay, because even though I'm not saying they're all like that, but my observations and perceptions of people that are gay, call me a homophobe if you want, but there's two aspects of being gay that I don't want to be. That's why I would never be gay. But if anybody happens to be gay, don't be that. I've got two things that you wouldn't want to be. Don't be that pathetic dude with lesser self-esteem that's following some other dude around, right? That's one of the reasons why being gay is not my thing. I don't see myself following some other dude around, and while the other dude's the shot caller and they be belittling you, telling you everything to do, and you're following them around, no opinions, lesser self-esteem, which would also be the kind that you let them take advantage of you and belittle you and all that. No go for me. And another aspect of that I wouldn't want to be, even if I was gay, I wouldn't want to be that guy that goes look for some other dude somewhere with lesser self-esteem that I could, for example, have him following me around, lesser self-esteem, and look for the one that's lesser self-esteem and peg him out as a fool and less intelligent so that I can be an ultimate manipulator or whatever the hell. I actually personally think, for the most part, a lot of that gay crowd, I don't know how much the percentage is, damn near a lot of them, I don't know what the percentage is, but a lot of them have that extreme. How many of those ones out there that are together or whatever, both of them, I don't want to say they're all like that, but I'm already saying, yeah, one's following the other around, and the other one's the shot caller, and one's the fool, and one's the asshole taking advantage and belittling the other. shit, why the hell would I want to be gay? I wouldn't want to be in a straight relationship like that. Just like in a straight relationship, I sure as, in a straight relationship, I wouldn't want to be that dude that's with this chick, right? And I'm belittling her and have her following me around all the time. Like I said earlier in the video, being like, you know, find, go hunting, looking to hook up for the one that has the least self-esteem, that would just listen to everything I say, that I could mentally blackmail and belittle and even abuse. That's a no-go for me. I don't believe in doing that shit. And I don't believe in being on the straight side, being the simp. Like I said, following some chick around and they're laughing at me or whatever. Taking all my money or whatever the hell, and be like, you know, I'm pathetically following them around or whatever, like desperation or whatever. But anyway, yeah, so talking about the simp. Hey, both the gay and straight people have the simp. The one that's following the other one around like a fool, well, you know, the other one is taking advantage of the fool. So both gay and straight people, in a sense, have the pathetic simp, lesser self-esteem as far as the dude, if not the abusive dude, or like, you know what I'm saying, you know, it's hilarious to think about. It's funny, but it's not funny. What I would say to just about anybody, buddy, is like, don't take advantage of anybody else or belittle anybody else, and don't let them take advantage of you. You know what I mean, too. And anything else, any other kind of rhetoric, if that other side of the tracks wants to call you some kind of phobe, if the gay side or trans side, just because of some reasonable value what I talk about, wants to call me a phobe, or on the straight side, the extreme feminist wants to call me some kind of, a misogynist or whatever the fuck that is, because they believe in, all dudes should be emasculated or whatever, like fucking Anita Sarkeesian. Remember, everybody was bashing her on YouTube. Yeah, the subject matter about her pretty much, I think, disappeared on YouTube. They still talk about her or not. That was a big thing. But yeah, as far as I'm concerned, I'd be on both sides of the tracks. People would be pissed without hearing me out or listening. One side, the gay side, and the trans side would be calling me a phobe, even though I say reasonable things, because that's the way some of them are. If you don't follow their narrative and coddle them, or take a percentage of your personal life on their demand to coddle them, you're automatically a phobe. You got to believe all the rhetoric. Or on the straight side, where on the straight side, the extreme feminist would be calling me misogynist, even though I call both out. The guy or the dude or the chick shouldn't take advantage of the other or abuse the other. One shouldn't be the manipulator, you know what I'm saying? But that's the way that is. That always what it is.